Penguin Random House Audio presents Being Reflected Upon. This is the author, Alice Notley. To Anne Waldman. I was reflecting the other night, meaning I was being reflected upon, that Sheridan Square is remarkably beautiful. Essay on Style, Frank O'Hara. Preface. I was trying to find out if anything had happened between 2000 and 2017. It was 2017, and I had just finished treatment for my first breast cancer. Did the fact of the cancer have any significance? And something must have happened at some point during those years. I had been sitting in Paris alone since Doug Oliver died in April of the big millennial year. What had been going on? An expanse of timelessness. But importantly, it wasn't a chronology, it was actual time, one thing altogether. Incidents I remembered emerged on top of those of previous times. It was stacked time. Friends and relations died, and I grieved having known them for so long. I would get seriously ill, or someone would. Was that it? And there was the newsworthy, and I wrote a lot of books. It doesn't matter when, except inside the one thought of it. I became more obvious to myself. I discovered I was an unabashed location of unreported events of the spirit, or timelessness, the real name of consciousness. I tried to let as many people as possible into my mind. I changed the past, the present, and future by blending them. I became the one who held things together as they, the things, kept their motions going, being reflected upon me. That kind of poem. It's lovely, no more radiation treatments, though everyone prefers being alarmed about politics to poetry, and that's a mistake, but it's a crisis, of course. I'm so happy not to go to l'Institut Curie, at least for months. I dreamed of an empty body, last night a decision as to what necklace should be put inside it. Last June, you knew all this was coming, yes, and every day writing poetry, creating the real, real world. I answered the phone to a telemarketer on Thursday, and a voice says in French, "I'm calling on behalf of Monsieur Lorenzo, the medium." I hung up laughing and thought of Lorenzo Thomas. After he died 2005, I dreamed he burst out of his coffin in Chicago, the Diversity Street house, where we first bonded 72. He was wearing a shower cap, but seemed to be exhorting me to, what? And dust. There was dust on him. It was a long time of agoes. Vietnam. My brother's just back, I said to him. Who would have thought, the poem says, I'd be still alive and in Paris, France for the health care. This dusty form is my beauty crystal necklace. You're smashing Lorenzo, great poet. Who we were? I can't figure what lasts on a tiny planet of phantasmagoria, except one's love. Winter 2013. Have you, Forsythia, proven John Forsyth? In the driven to remember rain or snow, I'm sinking syntax by vibe, okay? I'm going to that little theater in the 16th to see Le Neveu de Rameau. It is the year of Diderot. They talk incessantly, right? The Neveu is ragged, the Je figure more together. I sit in the corbeil, my knees hurt. Do you have a life? If I invent and accordingly by buzzes how to structure it, don't have to answer, period. All I keep of that experience, the metro, an image, metro Ranelagh, théâtre Ranelagh, walk down a hill, I'm bothered, staring between buildings at two red lights, that I can't have been here at all. Historically, when it evaporates, Paris, who will inspect our earthly ruins? What intelligence might be buzzed so much perceptible everywhere? Will they have senses? This, friends, is a group of created emanations for you to take in, whatever spot you're from, to understand me as I write, as I walk towards light and marquee. Is that why I bothered, or was I interested? Once there was a reign of terror, every afternoon. Why come ye not to court, John Skelton? Humans are like embroidery, tears, and insect scurryings, but you don't have that to whom I refer my address. Just another theater, another place for made-up stuff. Gravel ghost or gravel Gertie? I got the shuttle in Dallas. The man sitting beside me, window seat, slept. He was wearing new spiffy boots and a sort of combat outfit. Then he woke up, asked to get out, and came back from the restroom wide awake and talkative. Drugs? I remember he told me he'd been in, no, still did work for, the special forces. Had been in Europe just now, so I told him I lived in France, and we discussed how the Euro was doing. He said he also worked in Vegas, where we were headed, as a bodyguard for Sheldon Adelson. I couldn't remember who that was. The guy had in fact grown up in Vegas. I'd grown up in Needles. We were flying in over Lake Mead. I remember because I just came across a photo of a flower called Gravel Ghost, said to grow near Lake Mead, white petals, serrated top edges, here photographed as slightly blurry, ghostly. Going to Needles because Mama's dying. She used to gamble at the hotel, what was its name, in Henderson, where Adelson? The man next to me and I resemblant by coming from the same desert and knowing Europe. I will stay the night in the Doubletree. The lake is drying up. My brother was in LRR, not Special Forces in Nam. I used to be a pacifist, but now I'm nothing but soul. Gravel Gertie, the bag lady, and Dick Tracy was the local nickname in Needles for Marie, my heroine in my book of poems, Culture of One. Gravel Ghost, you beauty, you one-eyed star, purple verbena everywhere existent, and certain yellows, plus Indian paintbrush in Arizona, red. Agamemnon. You may have become too detached, knowing how to do things, though you can't stop. Like literacy. Those other shoes I haven't worn much high. Why, in that production of Agamemnon, did Cassandra wear platforms? And something about spit. No reason to accept the story you're given, right? I went to the play in 2011. The chorus was the same face projected on a screen numerous times with vocal overlap. I have never, and I refuse have been to be in a chorus. I cannot be the chorus, the community. I reject the concept, though. There you are. Prose is when you say what's approved or condemned. I mean poetry that's really prose, and in the chorus, you approve of prose, though you speak poetry unknowingly all your life. At that time, I but what, as in theater, the lines invade the actors. You in life cannot resist your lines. Bad poets talk about guilt, and you nod, but guilt is inarticulable, so the real poet leaves it out and expresses my anguish at being in a theater alone speaking French to someone who turned out to be English, dressed up in black. I remember how to be Cassandra. I remember disliking the mirror image politics of disagreement, allowing cruelty, pretense of being wronged, and you do get it. I don't ever, and don't hit back or click tongue callously. Given? Was it given? Can you stop whatever? No, I re-enter my apartment, do you? And do you win? Remember the hoax you have approved. I don't approve of anything. What I saw coming was only masses of wrong-headed traffic, air-killing, foolish, hurrying home. Everyone hurrying home from it, inside. Is nothing changing inside where you are? No. Have you changed yourself inside? Yes, I have, working on it in the most incomprehensible way. The chorus wouldn't. What about the spit out of which spit was created? And then I find I'm no common humanity, good out of focus. The building is old, and the play is older by Seneca, whose life moral question she walks, and I walk out of that theater having no more lines, no more chorus. The community is a hoax, then? Don't look at. Don't look at anyone with any words or stories. It's very pale like spit or clear snot. Just happened to be here, buzzing. There's a reason we love you, swirling like ghosts around you. But I was trying to remember the past 3,000 years. Sex concentrates mystery that permeates the universe. Are you an audience member now? There were never and nothing ever. It happened like at the Bataclan. The audience gets shot to pieces. If I can have enough space between thoughts, I'll find out who I am. But you know, and we love, I came to this venue to pay the price, didn't you? Or the kosher food store. Shrinking the mind is, because internet, too fast buzz, that wasn't what I said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.